It has been extraordinary to see the growth and the trajectory of the Institute over the past 20 years, and it continues to be to this day.
The Allen has had an extremely big impact on all of biosciences, and you know, it's been an enormous resource where people can come in and mine the data.
The idea of doing science in a very different way, as opposed to the traditional PI lab-based, you know, that was what drew me to the Allen Institute, right? And then when the open science piece of it came in, you know, we knew that, you know, we had really something, and the model was something that was really unique.
I used to say that we were open science before open science was cool. So again, it's hard to take yourself back to that time prior. But back in 2003, it was a very different world in terms of open and sharing and other things.
Good stewardship really demands that it is for the benefit of all. And this has been a core mission of the Brain Initiative, and I know it's a core mission of the Allen Institute, which is to develop resources for the benefit of all.
Allen Institute is unique in bringing together teams of highly expert scientists focusing on really hard problems and then being willing to give all the data away so the rest of the world can learn from it as quickly as possible. I really can't think of any other organization that does all of those things and does them as well as this institute does, both in brain science and in immunology and in cell science.
So I'm Sarah Freeman. I'm an assistant professor of neurobiology at Utah State University, and we're here at the Society for Neuroscience. So my lab studies the oxytocin system of the brain, and we're interested in finding out whether the densities of those receptors are different in the brains of individuals who had schizophrenia when they were alive. We wouldn't be able to do our work without the Allen Reference Atlas. It's, I would say, the sort of industry standard for doing this kind of work in human brain tissue, or mouse brain tissue for that matter.
My name is Ben. I'm a PhD student in Illinois Tech. Here we have a template brain that is called CCF, developed by Allen Institute. First of all, the CCF is very high quality, out of like Allen Institute. If we don't have it, I cannot imagine we need to make a sort of overseas CCF. I think that would be a disaster.
Your place is so wonderful. We're always using, of course, your transcriptomic modules that you have and all the wonderful websites you have for looking at transcriptomic profiling, but of course you also have your cell repository now.
Science pioneered at the Allen Institute will blast off into orbit this Sunday.
Together we expand what is possible in low Earth orbit.
Stage separation confirmed.
You know, it's something where I think the Allen Institute should be really proud of the resource that they provided for the community, because it's tremendous.
The Institute is a foundation for science everywhere, everybody. You know, computer science and biology and engineering, and pulling it all together. Collaboration is what leads to big discoveries.
It's just been such a privilege and an honor to be able to work with the Allen Institute for over 10 years now. Everybody at the Allen Institute is just an incredible scientist, and there's such a team spirit and a team focus on really making an impact. We just don't see things like that in other parts of our careers, and so it's just been an honor.
If you just stop and think about COVID and how a vaccine was produced in a record amount of time, it helps you understand the sheer power of science to save lives. And when you want to solve big scientific problems, you need a multi-dimensional, multi-angle approach. And that's what the Allen Institute is able to do.
It's really clear that advances in life science more and more depend upon team efforts, and efforts that are undergirded with technologies that may not be available everywhere, require a critical mass to put them together. That's what Allen Institute does. We just wouldn't be able to make the same rate of progress without this kind of approach that Allen Institute represents so well.
I am so excited about what the Allen Institute does. First of all, the research that is going to be life-changing that occurs here, the excitement here amongst the scientists that I met about how they're going to change the world, but also using the open science approach so that people all over the world can have access to this information, and the chances of having great successes in the future are just multiplied by that.
If I could say one thing, I'm sitting there during the lightning talks. Of all of the exciting things going on, I was just imagining what Paul would think. He would have been just glowing with happiness because the talks are talking about really hard problems from really energized investigators. It's exactly what he was hoping for.
Please join me in welcoming Dr. Zen to the stage. Thank you.
It's a tremendous honor to speak at the SFN to tell you about our work at the Allen Institute for Brain Science in understanding cell type diversity in the mammalian brain.
One of our charges while we're still out here on Earth is to figure out how to make quality of life better. And what's critical here to realize is that if we collaborate and bring in these diverse scientific perspectives, our chances of solving these huge problems really get much, much better. So I think this is a huge impact. Allen Institute has really shown how to do that. And it's been a wonderful collaboration as a partner between the Allen Institute, all of their collaborators, as well as funders like the NIH and the NIH Brain Initiative. And, you know, the next 10 years, they'll be better. And the next 20 years are going to be fantastic. So buckle up. It's going to be a fun ride.